Hello everyone, today we are going to start our new lesson from supplementary reader, or we can say An Alien Hand. An Alien Hand is a name of a book, or we can say title of the book. And our today's lesson name is The Tiny Teacher. And this lesson is all about ants. Have a pencil to write down difficult words meaning. So let's get started. Let me read the first paragraph. Near the smallest insect you have seen and the wisest. Is it the fly? No, it isn't. Is it the mosquito? No, not the mosquito. Here the author says that near the smallest insect, not only the smallest but also the wisest. And he asks here, is it the fly? No, it isn't. Is it the mosquito? No, not the mosquito. Then it must be the worm. No, none of these. It is the ant, the commonest, the smallest, but the wisest insect. Though the ant is the commonest, or we can say smallest insect, but it is the wisest insect. The story of an ant's life sounds almost untrue. Sounds means appears. The story of ant's life appears, or we can say looks almost untrue. But the people have kept ants as pets, domestic, and have watched their daily behavior closely. Behavior means here activities. Activities of the ants. So nearly, closely. So we know a number of facts, number of realities about this tiny. Tiny means small. Hardworking and intelligent creature, intelligent insect. Let us proceed to second paragraph. An ant uses its feelers or antenna to talk to other ants by passing messages through them. Watch a row of ants moving up or down the wall. Each ant greets all the other coming from the opposite direction by touching their feelers. Here, I think there is no any difficult word to explain. You might have understood the second paragraph. Have a look in the textbook here. So this one is called antenna, or you can say feelers. And have a look the row of the ants. We may notice in our home as well. So let us move to next paragraph. There are many kinds of ants. The commonest among them are the black or red ones. There are many kinds of ants, but the commonest among them are the red one or black one. We have seen them since we were children, but haven't paid enough attention to them. Where do they live? Here the author asks us, and he himself answers. In their comfortable homes called nests or anthills. Each has hundreds of little rooms and passages. Passages means paths. In some of these rooms, the queen ant lays eggs. Queen ant, name of a ant. Others are nurseries. Nurseries means rooms, or we can say place for the young ones called grubs. The young ones are known as grubs. Workers have their reserved quarters. Quarters means also here rooms. They spend most of their time searching for food. Who? Yes, ants. Have a look. Here the ants searching for food. Workers as well, you may notice. Then some rooms serve as storehouses for this food. Soldiers have separate barracks. Barracks means long rooms. No worker has ever tried to live in a soldier's house. No soldier has ever gone out searching for food. No worker, a soldier or cleaner has ever harmed a grub, or you can say the young ones. So you see, an ant's life is very peaceful. It does its share of work. How? Intelligently and bravely. And never fights with other members of the group. And never, fights with other members of the group. Then, here there is a comprehension check activity. Pause the video and complete this activity. Then, let us move forward. The queen is the mother of the entire population of the colony. Who? The queen ant, is the mother of the entire population of the colony. It lives for about 15 years. Who? The queen ant lives for about 15 years. Or you can say, its life span is 15 years. It has a pair of wings, but bites them off. Bites means cuts, but cuts them off, bites them off after its wedding flight. This flight takes place on a hot summer day. The queen leaves the nest and goes out to meet a male ant or drone high up in the air. On its return to earth, it gets rid. Rid means free. It gets free of its wings and then does nothing but lay eggs. Let us proceed to the next pair. Eggs hatch and grubs come out. Soldiers guard them. Eggs hatch and grubs, the young ones, babies, come out. Soldiers guard them. Whom? To the young ones. Workers feed and clean them and also carry them about daily for airing, exercise and sunshine. 2 or 3 weeks later, grubs become cocoons and lie without food or activity for 3 weeks more. Then the cocoons break and perfect ants appear. Now it's time for teaching and training. To whom? To the young ones. New ants learn their duties from old ants as workers. New ants learn their duties, their work, their way of life, living style of life from seniors, senior ants, as workers, soldiers, builders, cleaners, etc. After a few weeks training, the small ants are ready to go out into the big world of work. Let us proceed to next pair. An anthill is a home not only for ants but also for some other creatures. What is mentioned here? An anthill is a home for not only for ants but also for other creatures such as beetles, lesser breeds of ants and the green fly. So besides apart from what we can say ants, in their ant hill another insects also may live. For example, beetles. What are beetles? A kind of insect. Beetles is a one kind of insect. And green fly. Let me show you green fly. So this is green fly. So apart from ants, who live there? Yes, another insects including beetles, green fly. Why do ants want these alien creatures to live in their nests? Why do ants want these alien? Alien means outside. Alien means here outsider. Why do ants want these outsider creatures, insects, to live in their nests? What is the reason behind it? For several reasons. There are many reasons. Some give off smell pleasant to the ants. Some give off smell pleasant to the ants' senses. Others give sweet juices, and some are just pets or playthings like cats and dogs to human beings. The green fly is the ant's cow. Who? The green fly is the ant's cow. The ants train it to give honeydew like milk. What do you mean by honeydew? A sweet, sticky substance. Honeydew means a sweet, sticky substance like milk with a touch of their antenna, or we can say with their feelers. They milk it just as we milk the cow. Let us go to last paragraph. Have humans learned as much as ants have? Perhaps they have. Here the author asks us, have humans, human beings, learn as much as ants have? Perhaps, maybe they have, but they haven't put their learning to good use in their day-to-day life. They may still learn a few things from this tiny teacher. Means, yes, ant. Hard work, sense of duty and discipline, cleanliness, care for the young ones, and above all, a firm loyalty. A firm loyalty means devotion to the land where they live. Hope this first lesson from supplementary reader from an alien hand is clear to you. That's all for today. In my next video class, I will be teaching you second lesson from an alien hand.